Hello and welcome to the Kenosha County Public Safety Building. I'm John Morsey, Chief of Police for the City of Kenosha. You're currently located in the Chief's Conference Room, which is adjacent to my office. During the next 10 to 15 minutes, you'll be viewing a video on the history of the Kenosha Police Department. At the conclusion of the video, an officer from our department will act as a tour guide throughout the department. We ask that during the tour, you remain quiet and stay with your group. We hope you enjoy the video and the time you spent here at the Kenosha Police Department.
In April of 1850, the newly incorporated city of Kenosha experienced civil unrest, later known as the Wheat Riots. The Wheat Riots occurred because businessman C.I. Hutchinson swindled local farmers out of their wheat crops. These riots led to the birth of law enforcement in Kenosha after the city council gave Mayor Michael Frank and Marshal Jacob McKinney police powers in hopes of quelling the riots. Mayor Frank's law enforcement powers were again tested in 1850 when John McCaffrey murdered his wife Bridget. McCaffrey was arrested, found guilty after a lengthy trial, and sentenced to death by hanging. McCaffrey was executed August 21, 1851. As the population of Kenosha continued to grow in the mid-1800s, so did crime. Groups of young men and boys gathered on street corners, arson was a common occurrence, and disorder was on the rise. As a result, in 1882, James O'Brien and Joseph Newhouse were appointed as police officers. They were nicknamed the Blue Coats for the large blue coats they wore. One officer walked the day shift while the other walked the night shift, filling the four kerosene lanterns along Main Street. In the spring of 1885, by charter amendment, the office of city marshal was abolished and replaced by a chief of police. The first chief of police in Kenosha was Michael Harkins, and the 1800s saw seven different chiefs for Kenosha. The last, and one of Kenosha's most colorful, was Owen O'Hare. Prior to the 20th century, Owen O'Hare was one of only six police officers for the city. He was known to some as the Wyatt Earp of Kenosha. On Christmas Eve, 1902, Owen O'Hare lost his two front teeth in an attack by an assailant whom he later shoots and then recaptures. A major change takes place in 1903 when Kenosha's Police and Fire Commission is created by Mayor Fennig to handle the appointments, promotions, suspensions, and removal of employees. This commission took the decision about the police and fire departments out of the hands of the partisan city council and into the hands of the nonpartisan board. This was the beginning of the end of political patronage. In the early 20th century, Kenosha became a hobo haven to tramps that entered the city by train. These transients became a nuisance for law enforcement, and an order was later given by Mayor Gorman to shoot on sight any man found prowling about homes after nightfall. In 1906, Owen O'Hare is again appointed chief of police. This appointment received unanimous support from the Police and Fire Commission, as well as the citizens of Kenosha. His salary was $1,000 per year. In 1909, Chief O'Hare is shot while trying to incarcerate an alleged horse thief. Two nearby firefighters attempted to render aid, but O'Hare refused, stating, "Don't mind me, boys. Get after the horse thief." O'Hare gets to his feet and, bleeding from his chest, draws his revolver, firing at the fleeing man. The Colt worn by the suspect was found by two boys near the German Lutheran school. It had several holes in it, believed to be caused by Chief O'Hare's bullets. In 1910, with 13 sworn officers, the police department is located at 267 Market Street, which today would be 717 56th Street. A switchboard was installed at police headquarters and call boxes were placed in various sections of the city. Efficiency was doubled as officers were in quick contact with supervision. One of the low moments in the department's history occurred on March 31st, 1919, when Officer Antonio Pingator was killed in the line of duty. Pingator was shot in the chest by Earl Loveday. Loveday was one of three men who robbed the American Brass Company. He was eventually caught by Chief O'Hare and the Pinkertons, later convicted and sent to prison in Waupun. Officer Pingator was survived by his wife and eight children. He was laid to rest Wednesday, April 2nd, 1919. The Roaring Twenties brought with it the end of the O'Hare era. Thad Logan takes over as chief and asks for a complete reorganization of the police department. Uniform revolvers, better equipment, and a new police station are requested. During this era, Kenosha became one of the first cities in Wisconsin to recognize the need for women on the force. Beulah McNeil was appointed by the city manager as the first policewoman. He wanted someone motherly in law enforcement to help women and girls. Her salary was $140 per month. In 1925, the police department was temporarily relocated to 806 56th Street, the headquarters of the old county jail. This rickety Victorian building housed the sheriff and his family during the concluding decades of the 19th century. The department remained at that location until 1964, when the new police department was built on the corner of 56th Street and Sheridan Road. In 1934, Kenosha was second only to Milwaukee in adding a one-way radio system to its police force. 4 years later, Kenosha installed the two-way radio system. These milestones in communication are clearly displayed on the current Kenosha police patch. In 1944, a second woman, Beulah Hartwig, joins the Kenosha Police Department. She rises to the rank of deputy chief. April 14, 1952 saw the first civilian crossing guard program in Kenosha. 16 women occupy corners when a sharp increase in traffic and points of control became too numerous for officers to man. In 1956, Captain Ralph Fox initiates the department's first training program for officers. In the past, a new officer received very little formalized training. These training sessions were held in the upstairs of the Wisconsin Gas and Electric Company. In 1960, police officer Ronald Bruzis captures a tavern burglar and is shot by his accomplice. Officer Bruzis recovered after a bullet was removed from his chest. He received a merit award from the Wisconsin Professional Policemen's Association. A gun battle took place in 1963, seriously wounding Detective Cyril Ellison and a young girl he was protecting. Detective Ellison received the Valor Award. In 1964, construction begins on a new police department. The cost to build is just under $700,000. On Saturday, August 21st, 1965, with 115 sworn officers, 15 civilian workers, and under the leadership of Chief J. Leo Buckman, the new police department became operational. 1968 saw the beginning of the Kenosha Police Department's K-9 unit and a pre-neighborhood watch program called Operation Crime Stop. For the second time, tragedy struck within the Kenosha Police Department when on June 7th, 1973, Officer Gary Frey drowned during a training exercise as a member of the department's scuba team. Gary was 33 years old and a six-year veteran. He left behind a wife and two children. The Kenosha Police Department lost two other officers in the line of duty. Detective Donald Murphy died of a cerebral hemorrhage, and Officer Drew Bouye suffered a heart attack. May we never forget the years of dedicated service these officers bestowed upon our community. On May 17, 1981, the Kenosha Rotary Safety Center opens its doors for the first time. Officer Larry Moncher uses this site to run safety education programs for the children of Kenosha. The Rotary Safety Center continues serving the children of the community and recently celebrated its 28th anniversary in 2009. October 1982, the Kenosha Police Department moves to its current location inside the Public Safety Building. This building is also the home of the Sheriff's Department. Prior to this move, officers dispatch calls for service. After the move, calls were dispatched by joint services. In an interesting bit of trivia, at 4 a.m., Officer Charles Hannes dispatches the final call from the old police department at 56th Street and Sheridan Road. When the responding officer, Officer Perry, arrived on scene, he was acknowledged by joint service dispatch in the new public safety building. In 1988, Lieutenant Mike McNamara and Officer Jimmy Gerber were shot by a heavily armed suspect. The assailant took his life after shooting the two officers. Both officers would eventually return to active duty, and Gerber would later become the department's first DARE officer. In 1992, Officer Ken Duffy and Gene Hafke receive a Bronze Star for their service in the line of duty against a knife-wielding assailant. Duffy also was awarded the Purple Heart. On Tuesday, August 10, 1993, a man dressed in military fatigues dispensed a barrage of bullets at a local McDonald's restaurant. One person was killed and two others injured. The suspect ended his own life before police could apprehend him. In 1996, with a population of over 85,000 people and 172 sworn officers, the Kenosha Police Department installs the first in-squad computers. 8 years later, the first digital in-squad video system is installed. A similar system is also in place in all police department interview rooms. Of the 159 years of law enforcement in the city of Kenosha, only 19 different men have held the position of police chief. Chief John Morrissey will have the challenge of leading the Kenosha Police Department into the 21st century while honoring the history and values of the Kenosha Police Department. With every new day, the men and women of the Kenosha Police Department face new challenges in fighting crime and protecting the citizens of Kenosha. Their dedication to being the most professional law enforcement agency in the state of Wisconsin begins with strong leadership and a focus on fairness and equality to those they serve. Today's officer carries the same traditions and motto of our predecessors.
When a loved one is missing, we'll be there.
When you're the victim of a crime, we'll be there.
Cuando su familia pase por una tragedia, estaremos ahí.
Whenever you're in need, we'll be there.